Hello everybody, my name is Martine Dowden and today we're going to talk about Subgrid. To get started, I started a list of projects, and so what we're going to do is we're going to align them using grid, and then the insides of the individual projects are going to get aligned using Subgrid. Let's take a look at our HTML. Our HTML is pretty straightforward. Let's take a look at it closer. We have a list in which there are list items. Each list item is comprised of an image, the name of the project, what's in the div, which is the content, right? Which is the text description, as well as the link at the end. And what we are going to do is set this up to be in a grid laid out using a grid. And then we're going to use Subgrid in order to lay out the individual pieces inside of each project. Because as we can see, some of our project descriptions are much longer than others, and what we want is a nice grid layout where each of the titles, images, content, and links all align in one big grid pattern. So let's start with some basic CSS styles for our list itself. Our section has a class of projects, so we are going to go find the list inside of our projects. And then we're going to add list style type of none to our list. This will remove the bullet point. Then we're going to remove some padding so that we can align to the edge of our page. And then we're going to do a little bit of styling on our page itself. We're going to give some padding to the page, and then we're going to add a font family of sans serif. With our basic styles done, we can now focus on the grid itself. The first thing we're going to do is display the list in a grid. Then we're going to create columns for each of our projects. We have four projects, therefore four columns. And we want them each to be the same size, so we're going to use repeat. We have four columns, so four. And then min-max of 0 to 1fr. This puts our content in a grid pattern. Now we want to handle the individual list items. For each individual list item, we want to go ahead and give them a display of grid as well. And then we want the rows to be subgrid. Notice that our individual items now all end up in the top of our columns. So if I look at our tools, we will see that all of our list items are in that first column. There's only one cell. We need to define some rows for our content. Because we're using Subgrid, we're actually going to assign the row information to the parent, in this case, the list itself. Each image over here is 100 pixels in height. So we're going to start with 100. Then we have our title. I want to take as much room as we want for our title. Then the content, we're gonna let that take up all of the space that we have, and then max content for the link at the bottom. Now that we have rows, we can start assigning individual pieces of content to the rows themselves. Inside of our list items, we have a couple different items. We have the image, we have the header, we have the paragraph or the piece of description, which has a class of content. And finally, we have our anchor tag. Each of these can now be assigned a row on our columns. Our image is going to be in the first row. Our header is going to be on the second row. Our content is going to be on the third row. And our anchor tag is going to be on the fourth row. Notice that we haven't been able to move our content yet. The reason being is that our list item only occupies the first row of our grid. We need to make each individual list item take up the four rows in height. So we will use grid row again, but this time we want the list item to start at the first row and to end at the end of the fourth row, which means on the fifth line. Notice that our content now aligns itself in each of our rows. Our images, however, are overflowing and causing our content to shift. Let's handle our images. To prevent our images from being bigger than their container, we will give them a max width of 100%. Now that our images are no longer overflowing, we can see that we have four distinct columns where each piece of content is nicely laid out in a grid pattern. let's tweak our grid a little bit more. Let's add some space in between each of our columns. To do this, we will use gap. We can assign two numbers to gap, the first one being the space between our rows, we don't want any there, and our space between our columns. Let's add two rems of space between our columns. Notice that I am putting the gap on the parent property again. I am operating on the UL. This is because, again, the subgrid utilizes the grid of the parent to figure out its layout. Finally, let's align our images so that they are in the center of their column. To align the image, we will use justify self center. We are also going to align the headers so that they are all middle aligned or aligned in the center. Instead of being aligned at the top, we want them aligned in the middle. So let's go ahead and do that. This time we use the align self property. Justify handles our horizontal alignment while align handles our vertical alignment. What we have achieved here is a subgrid where our titles, our headers, our content, and our links are all laid out in a grid pattern. This, however, does not work in all browsers. Currently, I am using Firefox, but at this moment, grid is not supported in Chrome. Once we open Chrome, we can see that Subgrid isn't working as we expect. We get a different layout as we did in Firefox. Our content is no longer aligned like we want it. Let's create a fallback to prevent this issue for browsers that don't yet support Subgrid. For browsers that don't yet support Subgrid, we're going to use @supportsNot and give it an alternate layout. In our @rule, we're going to use grid template rows subgrid. Here, we're going to look for individual list item in our projects and alter their behavior. When subgrid is not supported, we're going to replace subgrid with grid and assign some rows. Although our content doesn't align as nicely as it did with subgrid, our call to action at the bottom to check out the project itself still works quite well and is still aligned. The advantage of creating an @support rule such as this one is that once the rule becomes supported by the browser, the part inside of the @supports will no longer be applied and we will get our subgrid. We don't need to remember to go update our code. It is simply waiting for the browser at this point. This also creates a fallback for older browsers. With this last piece, we have laid out our projects on a grid and each individual piece regarding the project on a subgrid. We've also created a fallback for those who don't yet support Subgrid. Thank you for watching. Please check out the links below, which include a link to the blog post that refers to all of the material that we covered today in this video. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Have a great day, everybody. Happy coding.